Spank and Marlin.
Over there. Over there.
Tim.
Over there.
Cat Marlin.
This is last call.
Fishing is all about the experience of being out in the water and all the excitement that comes with it. Come get lost in the adventure with me, Captain Ricky Wheeler. Hey, so it's a down day today on the OverUnder. I was doing a lot of rigging and a lot of boat work, just getting everything ready for a good long stand of fishing here. We're gonna have about 35 days straight, so it should be fun. But just doing some maintenance stuff today, doing some rigging, getting ready for some more dredge fishing, messing around with shad bodies, and I gotta fix the head in a little bit. No idea what's wrong with it, not too excited about it. But Joe's outside here cleaning up the fighting chair, so let's check it out. What's up, Joe?
Having a lot of fun today.
Well, it's a down day. Just doing a lot of little maintenance things and getting everything rigged up. Had a lot of shad bodies chewed up the past couple days, so trying to get ahead of the game. We have a lot of trips coming up soon. But we're just using these shad bodies for our dredges. Really hard to bring a lot of bait here with us. We're gonna be here for 3 months, so most days are pulling artificial dredges. I definitely prefer natural dredges, but we just can't do it. We can't bring enough bait, especially when we're going through 5 dozen dink baits a day for marlin and dolphin. So these come in handy and they do work. So go out and grab some of these, just 9-inch shad bodies. I like the blue and white the best, but a lot of people seem like black and pearl. Also going to be rigging up a bunch of new chaser baits today, just using the old favorite, Blue and White Islander. This is the flasher one, and then Black and Purple. Have a bunch of Expresses already rigged up, so almost ready to go. See you out there.
Here's one, Ricky. Here's one. Right here. Ready. You're the man.
Alright.
One go high, one go low. Well.
I'm under.
You're under. Hi. Nice.
Come on. Heads up. Alright. Heads up. That's a beast. What do you say, guys? Go to the right, get in the corner. There you go.
think, man? Fucking rad. Good ball. Green to me. Got a good angle on it. Whoa, there we go. That's up. Alright, okay. Bring it tip down, sit down to me. There we go.
We're doing good here.
Today was just one of those days where everything went wrong. Right now, Joe is fixing the steering on the boat down the hole. What you doing, Joe?
Contemplating committing suicide or giving another go at it. Oh, God.
So we are out doing a little bit of free diving for grouper right now. Steve just shot a nice Nassau grouper, and right now he's got a mutt and he's trying to get out of a hole. So, hasn't been too bad, pretty rough out, but fun thing to do on a lay day. A little bit of boat work this morning, and now we're out here goofing off on the tender to the Who Cares, and free diving with Steve and Joe. So, hopefully we'll come home with some grouper for dinner.
Oh yeah!
Woohoo! Check that one out. That's pretty cool. Good eating too. What do you got, Steve?
Bear and a hog snapper.
What happened on the hog?
Joe was headed down to hit it. I went down there and kind of dicked him out of it, but. Got it.
Whatever, it's in the boat.
I'm down here in Cat Island, just getting ready to rig up some baits for the upcoming week. I got a lot of baits to rig today. We are now dredge fishing for the rest of the season, so have a ton of chaser baits to rig up. You can go behind the squid chains because the dolphin here are just absolutely stupid. It goes crazy. But when you're up here rigging, you need your O-ring rigs for your naked ballyhoo or your floss rigs, whatever you prefer. Couple chugger heads, want to be ready for the blue marlin and white marlin, still eat them too. I like 3/8 ounce egg sinkers for my small ballyhoo. If you have peewees, 1/4 ounce is great, no problem there. My arrow, poke the eyes out, but make sure it's a small diameter arrow or else your ballyhoo will get broken head syndrome. Want your bait knife, your pre-cut floss, your chase baits, rigs, and also some, we have some swimming mullets to pull behind the squid chains. You also want a shirt that you've already ruined in Cat Island from catching a couple hundred dolphins. Check that off the list. And start putting some baits together. Get ready to go do some white marlin fishing. So, wish us luck. Another important thing you need when you're rigging baits is pre-cut floss. The way we do it in the Bahamas, take a case of clip and just start wrapping. Like probably 20 times. Get you 20 pre-cuts. Alright, shoot pretty good. Take your good floss scissors. There's your pre-cut floss. Clicks not only good for partying, it's good for fishing.
Got plenty of chaser baits, deal with all dolphin, and plenty of nakeds, a couple of chugger heads. That's your marlin fishing box in Cat Island, Bahamas. Here we go.
Selfish mayhem, child.
Say it's the latest and the greatest, but I know that it's not. Be somebody you don't wanna be. Didn't even exist last year, but now it's what we need.
Pop out.
Oh no, not me. Oh no, not me. 'Cause I'm headed home. I'm headed home. Trying to sail down something that you never
beat on. Go for it.
Guess it won't be green around here when they're born.
Real, 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 real. Crank, 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 crank.
Once it's really gone, then it's really gone for good. Just because you can doesn't mean that you should. Oh no, not here.
Got it.
Oh no, not now. 'Cause I'm headed home.
Yeah, you can.
I'm headed home.
Be careful, we should come over here. Bring a tip to me.
Go somewhere you never gone. Sing something that you never sung. Think about something that you never thought. If you're gonna give everything you got.
Okay, crank a little bit.
Oh yeah, right.
Let's
here.
Go back that way.
Oh yeah, right now.
Okay.
I'm headed home.
Crank a little bit.
I'm headed home. We're heading home. We're heading home. We're heading home. We're heading home.
Go up a little bit. Watch up. Watch up. Nice.
Good job.
Cole.
Another day on the over under. Joe's getting ready to climb through a hole. I don't think he's too excited about it.
No. I don't even know if I can fit.
He's got to go all the way back here. Way in the back there. Into the abyss. Let's see how this goes. Joe, why do you got to go back in the hole?
Hopefully a bilge pump.
What's wrong with it?
I don't know. We had a lot of water down here this morning. And bilge pumps have been going on more than normal. So we're going to investigate the situation.
Yeah.
Kind of ventilation.
Yep.
How was that?
As fun as it looked.
What's up, Joe?
All right. This is priming a fresh water system. Drink 34 waters before you come in down here. And what you're going to do, all right, this is quick and simple. It's hot as hell down here. This is a common problem we have. Water outlet. This is the water outlet hose on a cruise air unit. Basically, I'm going to pop that off. You can do this. We actually have a hose down here, which helps. What I'm going to do is back flush it. Pull this. Let me get some slack on there. I'll put this hose right in there and cool all the cooling system. When it gets high pressure, these pipes will get really, really hot. So basically what you want to do is back flush it with fresh water, and then I'll turn the unit on, and then it'll go into cooling mode. And then while I'm back flushing it, I'm going to take this hose off and then put this right on. There's so much pressure with the water that I put in there, it's gonna kick out, and the system will be pressurized and be ready to go. That's the way you deal with that when you get a high pressure on your air conditioning. Very, 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 very common problem. Everybody should know how to do it. And that's it for today, I hope.
So Jeff, now you just fixed a bunch of shit on the boat, let's talk about strategy for the tournament.
Strategy.
What's your strategy? What are we doing?
Strategy. Let's try to stay alone. That's our biggest strategy this whole week. Kind of don't want to fish in a pack. These people get packed up. We would like to try to fish in a 5 mile area for 3 days straight with nobody around. That's our goal. And when we're alone, we seem to do just fine. So that's the plan. I'm sure it'll work out.
There it is. Alright. Heads up, heads up, heads up, heads up. A little more gear. There you go. Joe, what do you think, man?
Oh, man. Pounded it out, and here we are. Lucky enough to get third.
Hold up. Get in there with me. Yes, sir.
Getting third place really wears you out. Good job, Joe.